Doing?
Can you hear us? Or does it need to go louder? How are you?
Not a great day for everyone.
Yes.
You know. Anyone's doing good today, then fuck you. Louder. Okay, louder? A little louder? Volumes? Everyone's saying, okay, one person says, a little louder. Maybe you need to turn your volume up.
Yeah. I have you on mute. Please turn it up.
I'm excited. This is the rain check of our little tournament here. Much louder.
Sorry.
I think that's what the people wanted to go.
They wanted it much louder, or it's better now. See, the people
check.
Yeah, I think people will like placate us and be like, it sounds good, but really it's like they're like, I'll listen to the VOD and be like, you couldn't hear shit. So all right, this is fine. I think
this is good.
Yeah, I have it cranked, but I can barely hear of my fan. All right,
well, that's your fan.
Yeah, I want to apologize for everybody for last week. You know, I have not had the best technical luck. Okay, that sounds good.
That sounds good.
First, breaking the internet, Sam's internet. And yeah. Then we tried to get it really done today. So we're on a passable internet, so hopefully good. And then the other thing that happened was, I was doing, if you remember the tournament from last year, Sam did this like glitzy, sparkly gold intro. I don't have as much experience that he does with that. So then I tried to do it. And in the rendering process, I lost everything. So
in the rendering process, you lost everything?
I was pretty much close to done. And then I was like, I'm going to break for lunch. And then I came back and I was like, oh, it's all gone. And you were like, oh, try and recover it. And it like just didn't come back. I was like, I didn't save that. So...
You never saved it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. So, but I was like,
you got to save it at least once, and then it does auto saves. A lesson.
For next time, I guess. Maybe I'll fix it up for the VOD. How's that?
Oh, and by the way, yep, we're in the same room.
Did it look like we weren't in the same room?
I think people are so used to us not being in the same room.
Yeah, this is why we really wanted to make sure we got it done. I know it's a Friday night and people aren't used to seeing us on a Friday here. How many people we got? We got our regular people? I'm not even sure if our regular Sunday people are going to be here. I apologize for anybody that's watching this on VOD or from your truck if you're watching the VOD.
Yeah, if you're watching from your truck. We're not teasing you. We have 118 people here. That's cool.
So, yeah, we had to get it done on a Friday because we like doing the tournament in person, and things are getting wild in life right now. You know what I'm saying?
Yes. Which brings me to my next point. Guys, I love this community. I have spent the last 2.5 years with you guys. It's coming up on 3 years or 2 years?
It's coming up in 3 years. Nope, yeah, two years.
Because 2020, think September 2020 we started this thing. I'm going to have to take a maternity leave.
Paternity leave.
Paternity leave. Yeah, paternity leave. You know, the baby's coming any day now, and I'm not going to be able to schedule and commit to doing these streams. I'll try and jump on as much as possible. I'll try and, like...
You'll be able to plan your life 10 minutes ahead of time.
Yeah, totally. I think that's it. I think that's it. If the stream's happening, I might be able to call in and be like, hey, I'm here. But... As I told Nate earlier, I was like, I think I gotta be the new Darren, you know, and be like the flaky streamer,
flaky streamer dad.
Yeah, flaky That's streamer dad. So I just want you guys to know that I'm gonna miss all you guys, but I'm gonna still try and be around and try and make sure this community. I think Timmy, I talked to Timmy today. He's serious about he wants to pull his own weight, you know. And guys, that's a lot of weight. no, he wants to. He is also such a fan of the stream and of the community that he wants to. Stream more and stuff is settling down in his life, and so he's gonna be able to pick up the slack a little bit. And I think Nate, you're gonna help out a little bit more. And
yeah, I will say though, Trailer Boys will take a bit of a break after this. You know, again, Sam has the baby coming very soon, and I'm still traveling around. So between the two of us, I mean, I guess Timmy could run it solo, but.
I don't think that's
pick him back. Idea. But I mean, I feel like we did a little bit of a break last time we did the tournament as well. Right?
Yeah.
I'm really pissed about those graphics, though. I mean, they weren't great. They were like cheesy, like glitter and gold on purpose. But I'm annoyed. I'll fix it for the.
It seems
I'll
like
fix
it's like it worse that you're talking about it so much.
It's annoying me. I've never failed
before. Yeah, and now you're making it annoy us.
Oh, okay.
You're making your annoyance our annoyance.
Transference. Yeah, now you're annoyed. Sam, I'll miss our battles, but take care of that new baby and that new baby manual. I can't read. Ancient Moss said, sleep now and save your energy.
Twingles, I am going to miss not you. You're one part of this I'm not gonna miss.
As you guys know, we are here for the Trailer Tournament of Champions Invitational, sponsored by Trailer Boys, brought to you by the Brown Brothers. This is the second one we've done.
Fuck you too, Schwingles.
Ow. Did that give you emotions?
Yeah.
I would say the tournament is a fun, weird idea. And again, remind everybody, the points don't really matter. This is just a silly game, and it's all, you know, whatever is going on, you know?
Yeah.
Right now, we can show you. Let me see what this looks like.
Vague innuendo.
Okay.
I'm only big. That's what she said.
No, I'm saying I give people boners.
I get that's still weird, vague innuendo.
I didn't think it was that vague. It was weird, definitely.
It's vague. It's pretty vague.
All right, so here is what the bracket's going to look like, everyone.
All right, we're cutting out. Wait, hold on. Let me check something.
We were doing that the other day. B3.
Check has. Turn that up. Check, check. Check, check. And we'll turn this down.
How's that?
Oh, snap. Skipping the intro round with that 2 seed. Well, with a 10-team seed, it's hard to really seed it evenly.
Yeah, you know there's the first round is the play-in round, really. This is how the NBA does it. So,
you'll see here our 8 and 9 seeds right there. We have Rex Bosworth going up against Beach That Makes You Old. And then also in this round one, we have Big Rowan versus Niamix. Niamix, last year, I think came in like second or third place. I should have looked this up for my memories. But that's there. And then, you know, we'll get to the quarterfinal rounds after that. So before I forget, congrats to everyone who made the top 10. Yes, Abby Sally, congrats to everyone who made the top 10. Again, we're going to remind everyone this is an invitational. So luckily all these people were available. You know, the whole theory was like if people weren't available, you know, we would get a sub. So next season, if you're like 10 and, you know, it doesn't make, you know, it's all loose. The points don't matter. Okay. You want to play something so they can...
Yeah, let's play something.
Like an audio test?
Yeah, here's a little audio test. You know those like Bruce Willis movies that they released Dime a Dozen? I think this is one of those.
Oh, like just like the cash grab?
Yeah, they all have like Michael Rooker and Bruce Willis.
Okay.
I think this is one of those.
The boxes are all like the same kind of Photoshop.
Yeah, yeah, things. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
How's the audio?
Yeah.
This is 476 Barbary, right?
Yeah, I'm renting this place.
No, I booked Barbary. It a month ago.
Wait, Barbarians!
Yeah, what are we supposed to do?
Barbarians.
Why don't you come inside, and we'll call these idiots. Why don't you just crash here?
Is this the ugliest Skarsgård? Or is there an uglier Skarsgård?
I don't know if you got a great look at this neighborhood.
What about the dad?
I don't think you should be out there by yourself.
Stellan?
It's dry and there's a lock on the door.
Dad? What about Stellan?
I'm Keith.
Tess.
Dad?
Yeah.
You this sperm made all these
and
guys.
And I'll sleep out here on the couch. Sunshine.
What other Skarsgård are there? God.
Sivan?
There's... The hot Skarsgård.
Peter.
Peter Sarsgaard.
Keith?
Is that not the same family?
No.
Okay. Keith?
Alexander's the hot one. No, Peter is Sarsgaard, not Skarsgård.
You want to know something funny? I'll tell you this. So, I've already told Sam this. But remember the one I watched of like subtitles burned into it? And I texted Zach, I was like, I don't like the subtitles burned into it. Not realizing that I was probably watching some bootleg channels thing.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like this doesn't have subtitles.
I turned the closed caption.
Mine, I had it off too. Maybe it was the 20th Century Fox.
This process might seem overwhelming. But with a little practice, it can soon become a pleasurable experience. This is perfectly natural.
Okay. Looks that cool? Is that cool?
Yes.
That's not a sign.
Looks that cool?
That looks cool. I'm having a heat stroke.
To help reduce plastic waste in our environment, America's beverage companies are carefully designing our bottles to be 100% recyclable. That means every bottle that's recycled can be turned into material we use to make new bottles.
Auto play on? Okay. Did you guys hear it? Could you hear it? Okay.
I think everything sounded good.
Yeah? Okay. I'm looking for chat. So, Here's what we're gonna do. Here's and you remind me if this is how it works. Okay, we are gonna play two trailers head to head, and then after we watch both of them, audience vote in a poll, 1 minute long, which one you like, and, and we're not weighting our points on it. So after we watch it, are we giving our impressions? Like, oh, I hated that. Are
we'll give our impressions. Okay. We'll put our fingers on the scales, but we don't. That's the only effect we have on things. We don't vote ourselves.
We're not telling the chat who submitted what until after the round.
Correct.
Okay. Cool. All Does that make sense to everyone else?
So, do you have the first couple?
Let me see. I think I do. There. Okay.
This is that's the sound effect if it's like a. We're going to the trailer pit. Is literally talking about how to use a computer. It's like watching my mom host the show.
Okay. How's it look over here?
What?
Okay. You ready for the first one?
Hit transition.
Okay. I just want to hit play first, right? All right. Or do I hit transition first?
Hit transition first, because there's the...
You must love going to church because you're
always reading the Bible. Ever since I got saved, I feel different. I feel good inside.
This winter, experience what critics are calling the greatest gospel triumph in decades, based on a true story about an African-American boy who deeply experiences salvation to then answer the call to go and preach the word of God to the world.
I like how the title keeps showing up.
Yeah.
Smoke? Is that supposed to be evil?
What?
I didn't think he was like being melted by smoke.
I think it was some crap.
This holiday, be sure to take the entire family to the must-see inspirational event of the year. The Youngest Evangelist and the Ministry of Music.
I'd first like to thank God for not just being ahead of my life, but He is my life. God draws you closer.
John, wake up!
What?
Based on a true story?
Coming soon this winter to a theater near you.
Whoa, someone started with some fire.
Yeah.
Wow.
Wait, this is only halfway through. No, we're not going to
no, we're, no, the trailer's over, but I think they have like a...
No.
All right. All right, that was really good.
That was strong. I like how, like, the kid's delivery of all the lines were, like, not great.
Yeah.
And, it sounded like he had an odd speech impediment that wasn't, like, part of the acting.
Definitely, like you know, you always get on me for, like, having my... You always say, like, how religious movies are my, you know, like...
Sandering
and whatnot. Like, if you just... But the thing that I love about religious movies is sometimes they think because it's a religious movie that, like, that will make the movie good. this kid will be a good actor because we'll pray him to be a good actor. Sometimes that don't work.
Sometimes that don't work.
Lots of times that don't work. This time that did not work.
What'd you think of the trailer?
I thought it was great because first off, I want to say what was it? The youngest evangelist?
Yeah.
The Youngest Evangelist and the Power of Music or something like that. Great title. But also, Young Evangelist is a great rap name.
It is. That is good.
It's like a really, like... I thought... But and I really appreciate that the trailer had me, and then it had that end scene of the kid... calling upon Jesus to save them from the car flying off a cliff.
You think the brakes were out? Because, like, if the brakes are out and you're going over a thing, like, wouldn't you try and, like, hit the guardrail to slow yourself down?
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, maybe.
You think she was doing it on purpose, though? Maybe?
I don't know what that is. I think the brakes were out because... a lot of times, again, I think these people don't have any, like, understanding of, you know, like, the religious, like, kind of thing is, like, we don't need to really understand how the world works. We just need to say that Jesus is helping us. And rarely you see things that are that literal as Jesus saving them, saving their lives literally.
Yeah.
It's always a metaphor. Jesus is actually, you know, going to help them realize they need to protest Harry Potter. I don't know. This is my fight song.
I mean, Jesus is winning, guys.
Jesus take the wheel. Yeah, very cool. And yeah, so, and again, that was like a really good pacing for the trailer. It was really silly and then got really action-packed there right at the end.
All right, well, let's see what's going head-to-head with that trailer. You ready?
Yes.
Jesus took the wheel and drove them off a bridge.
Why don't you should hit transition, then start it. Because that's why you hit transition first, is because the... buys time. I'll do the next one once it's happening.
Caught.
Noble of you, carrying me, the bastard.
That's an ugly, stupid word. You are mine. I've built a life for us. I love you, Tim. You've never given me cause to regret. Never.
I just found out my mother is a world-class liar. Oh. You just forget about me, man.
We've all been there. It's Woe Foxy, first time chatter.
Timothy. He is as real to as any living bus.
And I can't shake off. The name is still around. So I gotta be sharp and steal my soul.
Life can break you, love or save you. There's no
game. It looks like Amsterdam.
There's no game.
Who's threatening for you?
I don't know who I am. Grew up with a ghost for a father. Maybe he's alive somewhere.
I will help you find him. We can do it together.
I ran out of leads.
Yeah. What am I supposed to do?
Wait, I guess.
I don't know. Wait.
introspective, like, scene in the rain.
Those are Suzuki Sample. It's like an early version. It's like a Jeep made a Suzuki Sample.
I know what to take. There's some costume. This guy in the dam sells. I mean, his name is Valder. Now you give him 35 guilders. Tell him it's for me.
Do you think he went to Europe because his mom was a liar?
I am your son.
Caught from Worldwide Pictures.
All right, I have a question. Do you have any idea what that movie is about?
Yeah, I watched the trailer.
I watched the trailer. I have no idea.
We're home, honey. We're home.
I watched the trailer. I know what the movie's about. Did you notice, though, that both the movies we watched in this round both had, like, the title being blasted throughout the trailer?
Oh, true.
Isn't that funny?
Oh, that is funny.
He caught his mom in a lie about who his real dad was, and he went to Europe to track him down, and a ton of crazy shit happened.
Oh. Oh, really?
That's what I'm putting it together.
Okay.
Has anyone seen this movie?
She said his dad was dead, I think.
It ain't about shit besides being a movie called Caught.
It is, like, you rarely see movie trailers that have, like... Like, Zach's trailer was a vague trailer. But you got it. You got, like, all right.
There's enough there to, like, do what it's supposed to do, hook you into seeing the movie.
Yeah, yeah. There's not a lot to the Caught trailer. There's, like, a lot of, like, this guy gets moody, has to do with his parents, and...
His mom's a goddamn liar.
His mom's a goddamn liar, yeah. His dad's a ghost dad.
Here's what I bet you he looked at the picture of his dad that was in a picture frame, and then one day he was looking at the Sears catalog and he was like, "Dad?" And then he, like, takes the frame and smashes it, and then the picture falls out and it's the picture that came with the frame.
Yeah.
My dad was a model? And she's like, "No, you idiot." he runs a lot.
We need to do the vote.
All right, go for it. So okay. We're going to do a one-minute poll, and your options are The Youngest Evangelist and Caught. Good first round, you know, like, good first ones here. I liked both of those. And those are strong. And this is like this is how you can tell, like, we've got some good competitors. Because either one of those would have been a very strong showing in a regular Trailer Boys.
Yeah, those show. Both could have been Trailer of the Week.
Where to submit when it's our turn, and how do we know when? Punished Walrus, there is a private Discord channel where the instructions are. And I think you're in it. Let me check real quick. Because that's where all the stuff is going down. Let me see. Is Punished Followers not in this channel? Let me see. Balls. Are there any mods for our thing here? If you're not in there, Punished Walrus, just email me your first round of stuff.
All right, the poll is coming to a close. Which one would have you voted for? It's close. Wow.
I think I would go
with Caught. Wait.
I would go with Caught. Because I'm not Sam.
Oh, wow. Caught lost by 1 point to The Youngest Evangelist. All right, now who is
going? Look, if you didn't vote, let me just say, Youngest Evangelist won by 1 point.
Yeah, and today of all days, you should realize that voting matters.
You know what's funny is I would have, if I had my phone, I would have voted. Damn it. So, do we tell them who?
Yeah, we tell them.
So, the youngest evangelist was Big Row One, and Caught comes to us from Miamix.
Our number three. Caught was a good one.
Such a strong showing last time. I'm concerned about Punished Walrus not knowing where we are at. Can somebody in the channel ping him?
Hey. Punished Walrus is a... what's the character from The Wizard? You remember they're doing the finals and the kid won't show up?
Yeah. Oh, you know what? Punished Walrus might not be home yet. He might be on his phone.
Okay.
All right. Punished Walrus, if you're seeing this, feel free to email.
We can always delay his first round.
Yeah, we're also not doing the brackets in like the order that we've shown you. We're kind of just like throwing them around. So let me just update this.
Niamix, that was a great effort. Winner. Great season. Thank you so much for participating.
Was it 8?
I think
17-16. We'll say 18-17.
Sure. Doesn't matter.
No. But there we go. All right. Punished Walrus says, I don't know why I can't get the Discord invite. Are you not on the Discord already?
Who's next?
I thought we squared this away.
Oh, next is Rex Bosworth versus Beach That Makes You Old in no particular order. Yeah. So, do you have those set up? Rex Bosworth versus Beach That Makes You Old. Okay.
Nope. We need to.
Yeah.
I can do that part.
Well, no, you can't. Cause you didn't. And aspect ratio is crazy there. Alright. Okay. No order. This is either Rex Bosworth's trailer or Beach That Makes You Old trailer. Alright, ready? We're on for second round of round one.
From the man from Hong Kong.
Listen, there's a Chinese cop in town. He's beginning to annoy me. Yeah, I think he should meet with a slight accident.
Jimmy Wong Yu is the man from Hong Kong. A furious arsenal of martial arts. With his sights set on smashing organized crime.
Okay, look how awesome Caroline,
cut to the we have a sport.
Yeah.
We take the giant praying mantis, put him in the wooden cage, and make him fight for his life with his own kind. I thought you would enjoy such a sport.
You and Jack Wilson in a wooden cage. He's a very dangerous man.
George Lazenby.
Hey, it's
Jack Wilson.
James Bond.
Yeah.
Gunrunner, dope peddler, ruthless czar of international evil.
I've never met a Chinese yet.
See, guys with mustaches can do karate.
Yellow streak.
Told you.
Is that racist?
East meets West in a head-on clash with no holds barred. Ben Harvest, who made Bruce Lee a box office smash, have joined with Australia's action specialists to produce a death-defying spectacle that staggers the senses.
This guy's
The man from Hong Kong knows no rules. Everyone he runs across is never quite the same again.
Everyone he runs across
is never quite the same again.
How did that happen?
I killed him.
Really? Well, in that case, you deserve a cigar.
Thank you. I don't smoke.
Tell me, Inspector, do you often take white girls to bed?
I assume...
only on Tuesdays and Thursdays.
This is nice.
Acupuncture?
So do yourself a favor and answer a few questions.
省点劲儿吧, 被你妈来陪我, 我也不会告诉你.
Yeah, and I love you too.
I love that it translated as arse.
This is Australia, mate. Not 55 days at Peking.
Hey, don't give me any shit.
Provoke him at your peril.
What the lunatic stopped?
Nothing stands in his way. For long. Nobody's safe. From the man from Hong Kong.
Pretty good.
Pretty dope. What did you think?
I liked it. It was a little long.
Yeah, it was a little long.
I did like the that moment where the guy was like, "You killed him? Well, you deserve a cigar." And he slams his finger in the cigar box. Because I think like the implication there is that it was some sort of trap.
Yeah, like some James Bondy style stuff.
But we never got the setup for that. It was just a guy going like, "I don't smoke," and hurting a guy offering him a cigar.
Yeah. I liked that one. You know, I like those kung fu ones. I feel like if Timmy
where
was here,
the problematic button was. It's we've got a lot going on here. With a little bit of dip, we would have hit the problematic button.
No, there was a part where George Lazenby said a thing about a color.
Oh, I didn't hear that. There was a lot of problematic moments to that.
I'm sure. I mean, that was like the era where like that was going on. I mean, George Lazenby was supposed to be like a bad guy, right?
Yeah, and that movie was about like a guy from China in Australia, and at a time when like that was like a big deal. So
yeah, and like Australian is notoriously racist against Asian people. Is that true?
Is that?
I don't know. That was like Romper Stomper, right?
Is that? Romper Stomper? Oh, yeah. I
think there's a few like racist like skinhead movies with like Asians. I don't know. Maybe I'm just making stuff up. Maybe I'm starting a new thing. Australians racist against Asian people. But
maybe it is.
It's probably. Australians can be shockingly racist. Is it that shocking? I don't know. But I liked that movie. It looked really cool. I feel like if Timmy was here, he'd be like, "Oh, that guy went on to do this movie and this movie, and then something happened." You know, he's got all that trivia stuff. For me,
racism doesn't exist in Australia, so not problematic.
I really like that movie, though. I feel that was a very solid submission.
Yeah, that was a genuinely like good, like an enjoyable trailer. It was
I wanted
a little
to see
long.
The movie. Now.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
All right, next up.
Something's gotten into Maggie.
Oh! I may throw up.
Me first.
The devil's got her body and is looking to raise some hell.
I just gave her more hair.
Your hair's so big. Are you the devil?
That's what
trail.
And only this man can save her.
It's great.
He'll knock the devil out of her. If she doesn't get him first.
Is that the guy from Scrooge that plays like the director?
I'm gonna mess you up.
Maggie, watch it!
Get ready for a night of adventure.
Damn you!
Yes.
A night of romance.
I can't.
It's weird because they're
lighting. It's so ugly.
A night of terror.
Why is the toilet paper so high?
Oh, no.
A night of action.
In the trailer.
Yeah,
she just touches it.
I'm not well.
That's the second time he's punched her.
Don't know how to party.
I wish we had the problematic button working.
Just when you thought it was safe to fall in love.
Have you ever heard of that movie?
No.
I haven't either. That is a weird movie, dude. That is a weird, weird movie. I liked it. I liked it. I don't think
Nun beat was the best. Both trailers were a little long.
Yeah. Only 2:42 though, you know, like they weren't
over 2 minutes is a long trailer.
Okay. But yeah, I thought that was super weird. You know, I like those weird ones. I liked how it was that age when they did the, how do you call that animation? Where you're just like drawing over the frames?
Oh, rotoscope?
Yeah, it looked really janky. Also, like, it had a lot of odd slapstick comedy in it. You know, like, it was all over the place. All right, so the choices are Girlfriend from Hell, which we just watched, and Man from Hong Kong. So, get your votes on now.
You talk about this for a second. I'm going to go grab my water.
Okay. I was like, I'm going to go grab my phone so I can vote. We grab my phone off the desk in the other room when you come back?
Right now on the computer.
Yeah, but that's your vote. All right, so, Sam, did you see the man in that trailer? No. Girlfriend from Hell looks really interesting, but as trailers go, you weren't into it? I liked it. I would want to see, that's a tough thing, is like, if you put it as like what you'd want to see, I still would want to see both of those movies. Girlfriend from Hell looks ridiculous, because I'm like, really want to know what the point is. Was that other guy in the trench coat like an angel or something? I don't get it. Oh, Hal here says, anyone want to hop on Rocket League and trade? So, any takers? No, I don't think so. So vote now. This is a tight race. Oh my god! Wow, another pretty tight race. Girlfriend from Hell has won. 21-16. That was very close, everyone. Let me see. Girlfriend from Hell came to us from Beach That Makes You Old. So that means Rex Bosworth was the man from Hong Kong. There we go. Congratulations, Rex Bosworth. Beach That Makes You Old, thank you for playing. It was a good submission. I honestly thought Man from Hong Kong would take it. 21-16.
For what?
Girlfriend from Hell won with 21 points.
Oh, whoa.
And Hell here wants to know if you want to get on Rocket League and trade.
And train?
And trade.
Get on Rocket League and trade.
Yeah. Oh, wait. Oh.
Like trade goals?
I don't know. 21-16. Let's see. Wait. Did I get that wrong? I think I got that wrong.
Here.
Hold on. Who won? Gopher from Hell won, right? Yeah, okay, 21-16, Gopher from Hell winning. Rex Bosworth submitted Man from Hong Kong. Beach That Makes You Old submitted Gopher from Hell. So Beach That Makes You Old won that one. My bad. I got those backwards. Will you fix this here before you go on to the next thing? Put 21 here and 16 here. There we go. Thanks, guys. It's you know, the guy, the Discord names aren't the same as the chat names, so I got them a little backwards.
Okay, so let's check this out. We'll check in. We're ready for, that was the play-in, and Beach That Makes You Old and Big Row 1 both got in, and that's actually, neither of those were upsets, funny enough. So now we're just having a bracket tournament from 1 to 8.
But not in order. We're going to randomize
it. Yeah, we're going to randomize it,
We'll say this, though. So now, Beach That Makes You Old, if you're listening, you should now send us your second trailer. Big Row 1, direct message, a second trailer. Still got to check in a Punished Walrus. I don't know if I've seen him in chat. Punished a Noose. Lame, y'all missed out on some amazing trailers I had lined up. Lost to a lame comedy, all because Nuns with Guns for 5 seconds. Hey, them's the rules. I did think a band from Hong Kong would have won, though. You know, if Timmy was here, you know, maybe he's your trailer daddy next time. Oh, I'm gonna grab my telephone. I'll be right back because I can't tell if I'm being messaged directly with the trailer.
All right, here. Is that better? There we go.
Okay. So, let me just check something real quick.
Okay. Let's
trying to get Punished Walrus in the side chat. All right, pick. All right, you pick a bracket, and I'll tell you who they are.
I got one.
Hold on, let me see who they go up against.
They go up against.
Oh, yep. All right, Punish Waller's message us. We're all set. Everyone's in.
All right.
So now we're into the quarterfinals. So now we are down to 8. And this is where you're going to start seeing like, some of the big... the big stars. The top 3. Although I'll say, do you remember last year, Panwall was a number 1 seed, and I think Nymix knocked him out early.
Yeah, it was an upset. That's the thing about tournaments, is upsets do occur.
Yep, okay.
You gotta love an upset, you know?
All right, got it. Guys, just checking to make sure we're all here, moving right along.
All right, ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay.
ladies and gentlemen, Sorcery.
Another one of those things.
This is Stunt Rock. It's superhuman. Super music. Super magic.
Whoa!
And super amazing.
Whoa!
You'll be compelled over the edge of sight and sound. And under the spell of mind-boggling action and music, push to the danger zone.
Whoa!
It's a death wish at 120 decibels.
Fly in the highest heights! You fly the farthest lights! Living on normal time! Your life is on!
I think the wizard plays the flute. Like, when flutes all those things.
Like Jethro Tull.
You must survive the test. You'll be better than this.
You think when they jump a car into the water like that, they're in charge of getting it towed out, and they're just like, fuck it, it's in the water now. Oh, that was a genuine fall there. Getting faces of death.
Stunt Rock.
That's a dope shirt.
The ultimate rush.
Hey. What's the plot? Fuck you, explosion.
Jeez. I feel like that.
Wait, this film ventures international release.
Is that the name of the company?
I
feel like it was a bunch of stunt guys that also like played music, and they were like, we should make a movie about this.
Yeah.
And they're like, about what? And they're like, just doing stunts and rocking out. And they were like, cool, let's go. It just goes from stunt to stunt. It was like a musical Jackass of its day.
Australian stuntman Grant Page goes to Los Angeles to work on a television series. He uses his spare time to lend his explosive expertise to rock band Sorcery. Page helps the band develop pyrotechnic magic tricks for their shows and recounts to his own exploits as a stuntman in Daredevil, as well as various stunts by other greats.
Of course.
Okay.
It's so simple. I've never heard of that. Have you heard of that? So far, I haven't heard of, like, I think most of these movies.
Yeah. No, I've never heard of that.
All right, so that one is going to go head-to-head against this one.
That's the same director as the man from Hong Kong.
Oh, is it really? Is that true? That's nuts.
That's really funny. They, which both had the shot of someone shooting a van and it blowing up.
It that's true. How crazy is that?
Guy likes his shots.
Yeah. You know, directors like go back to the well, right? That's how that works. They go with what works.
Brian Trenchard Smith.
Trenchard?
Trenchard.
That's pretty fun, dude. All right. Whenever you are ready. We're going to
came back from the war and all I got was Trenchard.
Stunt Rock.
Good job.
It's not so easy.
What are you start saying?
What's wrong?
You were raping me? Ew!
Greatest master.
He was like, you're whole, I wanted oats!
Magic, the Liak magic! I'll accept this young girl. Starting tomorrow, she'll be my disciple. All right, and now the terms! Take off your skirt. I need to write a few mantras of Liak on your skin.
Why does she have to take off her skirt? What?
What?
Is that rotoscope? Crazy. What did you think of Mystics of Bali?
That was wild.
That was a weird, weird trailer.
Yeah.
Is that, is Bali a country or like a city in a country?
It's an island. Bali's an island, right? Yeah.
Is that like a Balisian movie, you think? Or do you think it was like a produced by another country and it's just
produced by another country? And yeah.
What country do you think that movie's from?
My guess would be a...
Bali is part of Indonesia, Principal Role says. Indonesian where Bali is. Oh, so the movie's Indonesian. All right, interesting. That was freaky deaky. I wonder, was there like an Indonesian film like revolution, you know, like that Italian horror vibe stuff? Because that makes me, like, just watching that, and, you know, maybe it's influenced by some of that Italian stuff, I'm like, I want to look into more of whatever that was. That was weird.
More or less problematic that the original Alien? I have no idea. But I don't get that comment. That was
the Kit music video. That's pretty true. Sam, what's your shirt?
It's the Kitty History shirt. The Kitty Illuminati.
Where'd you get it?
Lydia the Kittens, Not Chickens.
Yeah, .com.
Chicken, Not Kittens.
Yeah. It is Chicken, Not Kittens. .com.
Chicken, Not Kittens.
Get some cool merch there. All right. You want to put the poll up? We're doing... Stunt Rock versus, was it Mystics in Bali or Mystics in Bali, right?
Yeah, Mystics in Bali.
I do appreciate the effort going into editing some of these videos, you know. So this is the first round of the quarterfinals. We're doing...
I called the last ones round one and round two. I'm going to do it. This is round two. That was round one. Oh, quarterfinals. All right. I'm going to say quarterfinals, match one.
They're both very strong. I also think it's funny that the stunt rock was directed by the guy from the other round. Same vibes. here's my thing is what I got to think about this, right? It's like you have this weird kind of like art house thing that's from like an era, right? But then you have this like other piece of film from an era where it's like badass, like stunts and fucking rock and shit. So it's like those are both like two things that I think are rad.
Here's my thing. Okay. Is I really like, you know, I appreciate this like really weird movie, and there's truly some bizarreness to it, but I do really like movies where the stunts are wild. I love wild stunts, and not like high budget stunts necessarily, but like stunts where you're like, I feel like we see so little of that these days, where people stunts? Do genuine stunts. And so, yeah, I mean, I think like, you know, that's part of the Mission Impossible movies that's really cool, is that you see some genuine stunts. That's part of what was cool about Top Gun, is that they're actually doing stuff. And I think there's so much CG stuff out there that it kind of, like, makes movies a little less than. And, yeah, Stunt Rock, it seemed dangerous because it was cheap. What's my favorite beer? I do not drink alcohol. Straight edge. And not just I don't drink or don't, you know, do drugs. I listen to hardcore music. I'm straight edge. Earth Crisis.
Okay, so Stunt Rock won with 19 points.
Right, isn't Earth Crisis a straight edge
band? Yeah, Earth Crisis. Like you don't know.
Tree? Isn't that
nobody's gonna know Tree. Say like a Minor Threat.
Yeah, Minor Threat, yeah.
All right, so that looks like Stunt Rock won 19-10, and the winner is Hendo Calrissian, edging out Lobaka.
Lobaka, who also, Lobaka added the context in, and I was like, Lobaka, you're gonna be outing yourself as the one who submitted that trailer. Lobaka didn't even know that was the trailer they were going up against.
Lobaka, yeah, submitted. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Lobaka. I was saying the same thing. Like, Lobaka, shut up. You know, you don't want to tip your hat.
And then I realized, like, oh, this is the trailer going up against.
Yeah, yeah. So everyone else in chat, just shut the fuck up. Don't talk about a trailer. Everyone's going to think it's yours. But that is funny because it wasn't yours. But Lobaka, good showing. I really liked Mystics in Bali. That shit's bizarre as fuck. So Hendo Calrissian is the first one to make it into the semifinals. Hendo, welcome to the semis. All right, next we are going with...
Yeah, do that one.
Okay, so let me see. And again, if you're going up and you see somebody, a trailer play... Oh, actually, I guess they won't know if we're playing their trailer or not, but I'll let you know.
If there's a double?
Yeah.
Well, we can see if there's a double.
Yeah, we'll tell them who it is. But letting them know, like, what happens is if your trailer has already been chosen and you're like, oh, that's my trailer, and I'm like, nope, it's not, then you gotta pick another one, and I apologize in advance.
But, like, in one round, we can, like...
Figure it out, yeah. Well, that's why everybody was told to, like, pocket, like, you know, 5 or 6 trailers, you know? Because what will happen is if their first pick goes and somebody's like, oh, they took my trailer, then we're like, hey, what's your next pick, you know? So I should probably look at that before we even play this, right? So it's this
dude. That's what I'm saying.
Versus this dude.
So, yeah, people should never have to play against... Watch out for... We'll check for those double submissions.
Okay. All right, we're good. Are you ready? I'll let you do the honors. Oh, wait, I should move that screen out of the way.
Let me tell you something, buddy boy. Nothing's safe in this world.
Is that Jeff Fahey?
He told his son the truth.
From Mama or Man?
From the man who killed your whole family. And I'm gonna kill you. He survived. Now he's a cop who can't kill enough killers.
Okay.
believe you'd like to find the murderers of your family. Believe me, I can help.
Have you ever heard of J.I.?
What does J.I. stand for?
Justice Incorporated. Kill him.
Stunts, you're getting stunts. Oh, that was cool. Sick! That's like the third in the one car chase. There's like three like explosion footballers. This is crazy. It's a real stunt trip.
I love the real, like, scummy looking Jeff Fahey.
Oh, it's tied down the time.
They told him the rules going in. No way out. But there are no rules for the sweeper.
I thought the
rules. C. Thomas Howell.
Oh, it's C. Thomas Howell. Oh, yeah, okay. Which one's the sweeper, C. Thomas Howell or Jeff Fahey?
Wow.
That was really cool. I also like movies that are like, we told him the rules, and the guy's like, no way out. There are no rules. And he was like, wait, what's no way out?
Isn't that a rule?
It's more of a guideline.
C. Thomas Howell, that's really funny. Like, it looks so fake, them trying to like badass him up, you know? You know?
Yeah.
Because he's not a badass.
We got people talking about punk rock now. Everyone's talking about Minor Threat and Black Flag and Minutemen. Great.
You love talking about punk rock.
Not when there's trailers to watch.
True. You hate distracting from trailers. I thought that was cool.
I thought that was very cool.
Very action-y. The C. Thomas Howell punter was really funny. Because he did look kind of funny. I was like, who is that guy? It looks vaguely familiar. But like that looked like a taped-on goatee.
That's a cast I love to see. Especially in a 90s movie, is Jeff Fahey and C. Thomas Howell. Like, a past his prime C. Thomas Howell and a never had his prime Jeff Fahey. Like, that's a good cast.
Yeah.
The El Royale is a bi-state establishment. You have the option to choose a room in either California or Nevada.
How'd you end up at the El Royale?
The Ritz-Carlton was booked.
This place used to be hustling and busting. Old Dean Martin even sang a song about it once.
This is not a place for a priest, Father. You shouldn't be here.
We might need to work on your sales pitch, son. The El Royale. No place for a priest.
Juicy.
Break away.
Is this a horror movie?
Lonely nights that come.
It's a suspense.
Where you watch me?
Suspense.
I only watch
thriller.
Who they tell me to watch.
Who's they?
Management.
Baby, it's my.
Would you mind opening up the door?
No, I ain't gonna do that.
We have to get as far away from him as possible.
Howdy.
It's Thor.
Yeah.
I'm not really a priest.
Yeah. No shit.
Cool. That I would say generally that looked like a cool movie. I want to see. I've heard of it. I've never seen it.
I've seen the trailer for it before. I don't think I've seen that trailer for it before. I was surprised. This is the first movie of any of the movies that I've heard of. And I was surprised to see such like a widely known movie. I bet there's a lot of people in chat that have seen that movie. But the tough thing for me is, I'm going to put up the poll while I'm talking about it.
The tough thing for you in this context of the tournament?
In the tournament between the two, is the sweeper was maybe the highlight of the night for me so far. So
that's big praise.
I'm sorry to give things that much praise, but I was surprised to see Bad Times at the El Royale
with an E, Royale.
I was expecting to not. Oh wait, I can't even
put it's okay.
The E. I was expecting to not like the trailer as much as I liked it.
So counterpoint to that, me saying like of those two, like the sweeper was like schlocky, but like of those two, if we're like let's watch a movie of those two right now, I'm gonna pick El Royale.
Yeah, I do think it's also it's a bigger swing to take to pick a new movie that everyone's heard of. I think there is something to like pick something that's schlocky and fun and but I just really, really liked the sweeper trailer. And I mean, I think the sweeper trailer for me was, what was the tagline? It was like, he survived, now he's addicted to killing killers.
I did not.
He's a cop who can't stop killing killers or something like that.
I think that went over my head.
That was rad. Okay. That's such a rad line.
That was rad. I didn't hear it. I heard the not playing by the rules one. I went with El Royale.
Maybe. Whoa.
Did I put too much of a finger on the scale?
Whoa. No, look at it. We've got a first tie.
I don't know what we didn't have a tie last year.
Should we ask Emily? Tell her the name of the both of them and see which one she...
Just based on name?
Yeah, just based on name.
Or we could each have them do another trailer. Like no. No? Okay. All right.
Or we could have them do another best out of seven. And you want to add like another 10 minutes, 15 minutes to the show?
She hasn't seen the trailers. You're just going by title.
I don't know. Flip a coin? I don't know.
Hey, it's your show. You do what you want.
What do you you want them to pick another trailer?
Yeah.
No.
Okay. What do you think? Measure Dicks? Best of 20? Flip a coin?
All right. Someone who hasn't voted. Vote.
Should we do another poll? One more poll?
The W Jeans. The W Jeans was too busy buying WKUK merchandise to vote. What if we asked the W Jeans who they think should win as the tiebreaker? All right.
Wow.
Vote.
It's poll, not vote.
Someone was saying, someone was saying, let's do it again. A lot of people were away.
Do people not know what we're doing?
Vote. Times. At. Well. The sweeper.
See, we're in a split decision here because
we're gonna do a vote once again because
even between us we're split, so it's not like the both of us could even be like on the same page here.
Yeah,
this is too intense for Lydia Petunia. Lydia Petunia, I thought you were here to win, and I'm here to make friends. It's too intense for you.
I'm not vegan. I'm not actually straight edge. I just don't drink and don't do drugs.
You drink coffee. That's caffeine.
Yeah,
that's against straight edge.
I also
and you fuck.
Yeah, and I do.
All right, so the polling is up now. So if you did vote before, please vote again. If you didn't vote before, please vote now.
Damn, I feel like Sam almost read my comment. Then he stopped. What a dick. Lol.
Because I interrupted.
Fuck you.
Okay, revote is on now. And
are you voting?
Close. I should vote, right?
If you vote, tell me if you're voting.
I'm voting.
All right.
Our votes cancel each other out.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, wow.
Oh, bad times at the Royale
1.
Okay, so it was 20-17 bad times. So that's a surprising for me, because I didn't think a lot of people would get down with a newer trailer, but that's a risk. And Grimward, congratulations, moving on to the next round.
Punished Anus, that was a good trailer.
Just Edge, I thought you got robbed. Anus. So sorry, Punished Anus. And that was a 5-4 seed. Those were the fourth and fifth, so that's the closest we have in the bracket.
But still not an upset.
Yeah, not an upset.
Hendo was an upset.
Hendo beat Lobaka, that was an upset there.
Okay.
Here or here?
There.
There? Okay. All right. Are we here?
Just go with that one, actually, though.
But this is like, where is this?
That's the
over here
top. Okay, yeah, that one. Just go with that one.
All right.
Just because it's already embarked as red, you know?
Yep. It's a smart. You're a smart guy. Okay. You know what it is I see the cursor, and I'm like, oh, it's there. All right. You know when, like, you use somebody else's computer and it's not your own, so you're like, how do I use a computer? That's how I feel right now. Oh, you know what, too? Sorry.
What?
I feel like this scene should go up behind this, right?
Sure.
Yeah, that's how it's supposed to, that's why I kept getting that weird fucking shit. I think that looks good, right? Is it muted?
Oh, wait.
I can't hear it. All right, that's...
Her name is Angel.
There we go.
4 years ago, she walked the streets of Hollywood. Today, she's graduating college.
I've seen this movie.
Streets, I hated cops.
Even Linda
you.
Blair, I think.
But when the cop who changed her life is murdered.
The last thing Andrew said before he died was Angel.
Angel's back on the boulevard with a vengeance. Avenging Angel.
I'm looking for Andrew's killer.
The cops will help her.
Please raise your hand.
What do you think you are doing?
You were doing a job. I wouldn't have to.
The mob wants her dead. The only
she
one she
yellow
can turn
sunglasses.
To are the street people. Real friends like Kit Carson. Solid.
Sam Shepard.
I can do it.
New friends like Johnny Glitter.
The light. Intoxicating.
This
the
is girls. Exactly what LA is like little all buck. The time.
Together, they're the most
unexpected.
They have a baby?
Little buck.
At this point, pull the trigger.
Crime fighting force.
Yeah.
A
Hollywood has ever seen.
Those guys are pros.
This is so weird.
The Hollywood story of the student by day, hooker by night continues.
You're more of a prostitute than I ever was.
Damn, AK got you.
Avenging Angel.
When you get to hell, tell him an angel sent you.
That's a good line.
Avenging Angel, her all new Hollywood story.
That was good.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe I saw Angel. Maybe not Avenging Angel. Maybe I saw Angel.
Yeah, that one looks more like Linda Blair. That was really funny because I didn't realize they were like doing a team up. You know, I wonder if this was originally submitted during the team up thing. Yeah. It was like a cowboy, a glitter man,
a baby
that didn't seem to belong to anybody on the team.
Yeah, it was just kind of like there's all the freaks come down to Hollywood Boulevard like this baby.
This is very weird, man. I had not heard of that. All right, this is where we are. Who played the cop that was like her mentor that got killed? Because that kind of looked like a familiar person.
Tom Hanks.
That's so weird.
Okay, yeah, so Angel was the one I saw. And I don't know if Linda Blair might not be in that one either, but that was Angel was the one I saw. I think that's the sequel to Angel.
Evangelist and Angels will team up, yeah. The youngest evangelist, a cowboy, a glitter man, a student / prostitute / like vengeance detective. Yeah, that was really weird. That was Ozzie Davis, right? Oh, okay.
All right, let's see.
What are you looking at?
The cast of Avenging Angel.
Is it a sequel to Angel?
Yeah.
Oh, it really is? That's funny.
Ozzie Davis was that one cop.
You're more of a prostitute than I ever was. Is it prostitute or did she say hooker?
Prostitute. Let's see. I think maybe it was... I don't know what this guy's been.
All right. Well, we'll check it out later.
Wish 3? Do you recognize him from Death Wish 3?
No.
Or maybe the movie or the TV show Family Law. Do you recognize him from Family Law?
Oh, of course. That's what it is.
Mike
Hammer?
It was
Vengeance Detective, not Revenge. Did I say Revenge Detective? I meant Vengeance Detective. I do think you should get some of those yellow like shooting glasses, though, you know? Just walk around people like that guy shoots.
Yeah, yeah. Don't that's what you that want people to think. Shoots. You shoot like, this day and age.
Just shoot fucking viable sperm. It's ready to go. Yeah, you can.
Oh, okay.
Spanx. Rothrock?
Looks like the lift.
I command you to leave!
Sick. It's dope. I didn't know that was going as well.
Close the door.
Kill her!
There's been a bunch of swastikas in this trailer. But... I don't think they're Nazi swastikas.
This is weird.
What?
It keeps taking off.
Yeah.
It's now a full circle.
I mean, maybe they're Nazi swastikas? I don't know. I haven't seen any, real Nazi. Yeah, aren't they? There's, I've heard the whole religious symbol thing. I think this is legitimately the first time I've ever seen it used in that way.
If this the Buddhist symbol is the scene is in a movie, in the trailer, how long do you think this helicopter thing has in this movie? And the movie's called Thunder Cops because obviously it's called Thunder Cops.
Yeah, Thunder Cops, of course.
Oh my god! Which one of them are cops?
I mean, yeah, I know the thing about them being Buddhist symbols, but I just haven't seen them. I haven't been oh, there they are being used as Buddhist symbols.
Yeah.
And so when you see a yellow flyer surrounded with swastikas, the first thing you think isn't Buddhist prayer.
Also, I feel like you didn't see them as much after 1945.
Yeah. I mean, do you see that?
Yeah. I mean, all the stuff in the middle wouldn't make me think German Nazis.
Yeah.
But I get what you're saying.
I'm just saying that.
So Thunder Cops.
Thunder Cops.
Was there thunder in that?
I mean, there's a lot of music, so we wouldn't hear the thunder. the thunder, maybe it's the thunder of the guns, the thunder of the...
Let's just recap Thunder Cops, though. It was they're in a hotel, and there's a building, and there's I thought it was caution tape, right? And then, I'm not really sure what's happening. And then a bunch of, a gang, I assume, and there was, a bunch of women and one guy pull out guns, and then they're shooting at, a guy in a cart or a body on the cart, and then it cuts to a scene where it's,
zombies?
Zombies, right? And then a woman takes a thing, and the zombies have, maybe that was, thunder or whatever, and then they get vanished into a door. And then there's a floating head woman, and then everyone chases the head with the control helicopter.
The helicopters.
And that goes on for a big chunk of the movie, and then she stops and takes a rest, and everybody with the remote control helicopters drives it into her head, and it slices her head up. And is that the end of the movie, you think?
Yeah, I think we saw the whole thing.
Oh, man. That's crazy.
No, I don't know.
And it was Thunder Cops. The Aristocrats.
What was the other movie called?
Avenging Angel.
Oh,
Avenging Angel, prostitute that her life was turned around by a police officer who was murdered, and she avenged him. And her name was Angel. That was the other part of that. And then her gang...
Which is a sequel of a movie called Angel that is all about there's a serial killer killing prostitutes, and she is an A student who by night is a...
prostitute.
A prostitute, yeah.
And then the the police guy helps her.
Yeah, I think, yeah, he helps her, kind of. He's trying to find the... I think that's what that was about.
Wait, but. Thunder Cops is a sequel about a woman dealing with sexism in the police force? That's crazy, because that would sound like Angel. Where was my...
Yeah.
All right, if you're voting now, I feel like we have to tell people when we're putting the vote up.
Oh, yeah, it's up, it's up.
Because it's almost done, and I was like, oh, I forgot to vote, because I forgot it was up. Quarterfinals. Boom.
Poll is up.
Poll is up. Whoa.
Oh, it was a big one. Thunder 23 Cops. 23 to 6
Thunder
one.
Cops.
Yeah.
That. The Thunder Cops came to us from Flanja.
Flanja.
Flanja, winner of the season 2. Flanja comes in hard with his first quarterfinal pick with, was it 23 votes? 23 votes. What would you go there? I feel like you were leaning towards Avenging Angel.
No, Thunder Cops.
Oh, okay, okay. Beach That Makes You Old.
I loved how many turns the trailer had. I loved that, yeah. Like, when it first started...
It was all left.
I didn't even think it was, like, there was, like, the stuff going on in the beginning of the trailer, I didn't even think it was, like, a modern-day kind of, like, I thought it might have been, take place in an older period. Yeah. And then...
All right, will you console Beach That Makes You Old and let him down easily?
Beach That Makes You Old, so sorry. That was a good effort. Real fun time. Real good. Good trailing with you today. Flanja, I like Thunder Cops. That was a good trailer. Good job. Yeah. And this next one's set up. All right, cool. Ready to go. Beach It Makes You Old. Taoist swastika, by the way. The Taoist monk and spirits are performing an exorcism. The cops / bads stumble in and mess it up. Oh, okay, cool. Yeah, no, I figured that it wasn't a Nazi swastika. We didn't see any Nazis. No, it's just funny Nazis, to like see that, you know, to see, you know, like the Buddhist Taoist one, you know? All right, here we go.
Good afternoon, boys and girls. So how many of you have ever had to kill a zombie?
Well, not too many.
What would we do without our zombies? They take care of your jobs.
Give me that. This is detail work. Flesh-eating maniacs need not apply.
Do the housework.
What is that zombie doing in my easy boy?
And play with the kids.
Nice catch, Fido.
Names are zombie anyway.
Mr. Theopolis has a name for his.
I bet he does.
Nicely done, Tammy.
But for the sake of your neighbors, please keep them fed.
Oh, jeez. That's Mrs. Henderson. We're in trouble, boy.
20, 24 hours ago. Is that blood on your zombie?
It was a nosebleed. You stupid zombie. Help! Is Timmy in trouble?
Families having to kill their own. Take Dee Dee's head off in a second if I had to.
He always says that. Is that bad?
Yes. My God.
Hold on. I don't want you thinking what we did is normal or okay in any way.
I don't.
Right out.
So without my job, we'd all be dead. Then where would we be?
Dead.
That's right.
That's a good line.
That's the guy from the first Mission Impossible.
From what?
First, that's the guy from Mission Impossible 1.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
The first Mission Impossible movie.
The best second Mission Impossible. Best.
Second one is the worst.
Second one's the worst, for sure.
Have you seen that, Fido?
I have not seen that.
I've seen the cover somewhere. I have not seen it as a movie, though. And it's like, zombies are slaves? Is that kind of the thing? What I didn't understand there was, like, when the zombie, like, bit that lady in the face, it's like, watchers, it's like, yeah, of course, that's what zombies do, right? You know, like...
Yeah.
Mina Lin said, I just got here, I hope I didn't miss much. We are about to watch the last trailer of the quarterfinals, then we're going into the semis. Okay. What are we looking at now?
All right. Yeah.
Okay. The one we just watched was called Fido. I did like that ending line.
Yeah.
If it weren't for me, we'd all be dead. And then where would we be?
Happy Halloween, Tommy.
Something for me? Because I'm special?
Yes, Tommy.
Trick or treat, give me all your candy or I'll blow your head off.
Roger, would you learn how to talk nicely to your sister?
Bing, Bing, you're dead.
Tommy, we have to wash that.
But Mom, I like the taste of blood. Grandpa says it's good for me.
Grandpa? When did you see Grandpa, Tommy? Did he give you that pumpkin?
Grandfather's from?
Okay.
What was it called? Hack-O-Lantern. Which is a weird name for that. I wouldn't have...
Yeah.
If you were like, guess the name of this movie, I wouldn't have said Hack-O-Lantern. So Hack-O-Lantern versus Fido. What do you think of Hack-O-Lantern?
I thought that was good. I have a suspicion about that. I kind of want to wait till after the votes to ask about that.
Fido versus Hack-O-Lantern.
It's funny that they're both like these like horror comedy kind of things. I really liked the moment of the kid like getting in bed and like dreaming, and then all of a sudden it's like he's dreaming of being one of these rock stars. I thought that was really cool.
When it did the point where he was like sucking the blood off his finger, the way the angle looked, it looked like he was sucking his mom's finger blood, and I was like, what is going on?
Yeah.
That's weird.
You were like, What is going on? That is what I'm into.
Who knew? I know it now. All right, let's put the poll up now.
Poll is going
again.
Up.
If you're kind of passively watching, the poll only is a minute long, so you want to pull up your shit and vote now. Should we adjust our exposure? Are we too dark now? I don't know.
Yeah, I'm bringing
it. I'm a fidgety bitch. Of those two, the thing is, I've heard of Fido, and the premise is easy, you know, to figure out, right? Zombies as like pets. The premise of Hack-O-Lantern I didn't really get. It's like the grandfather gave the boy a jack-o'-lantern.
I feel like the grandfather is like a Satanist of sorts, okay. And the mom knows that, and the grandfather's kind of trying to get the son to partake in some sort of ritual.
Okay. Kind of like a Hereditary type of thing?
Yeah, yeah, okay. Kind of like okay. A Hereditary. Kind
and of then the band, they kept cutting to the band a lot.
Yeah.
So I thought it was like a dream sequence, but you think they're in the movie a bunch? Because they're in the trailer a lot. It was almost like a music video.
All right, Hack-O-Lantern 1, I got a question for the chat.
Hold on. Hack-O-Lantern 1 with, what were the votes here?
22-12.
22-12. Wow.
That's a big upset. That's Schwingles. I gotta say. I take no joy in saying that. You sorry, bud. Not this time.
So mean.
No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding, Schwingles. I'm so sorry. That was a valiant effort. My the one thing I wanted to say, and this is, I didn't want to tip the scales for this. My asshole, Sam. All right. Hey, I'm technically a millennial, so bring it here.
No, but if you get your ass eaten, you don't have to be a millennial. You're only a millennial. Oh, wait.
No, I'd be eating Schwingles' asshole.
But Schwingles yeah. doesn't have to be a millennial.
No.
You're, all right.
Yeah, I don't know sorry, why you're trying to.
Oh, I just got confused.
But my theory is Big Row 1, did you edit? Yeah. I edited that trailer myself, and I'm glad you liked it. I thought that was a fan trailer, and I thought you did a really good job, and that's why I held off, because I didn't want to give you bonus points for that. I wanted people just to judge it, like, being like, oh, it's just on the merit of the trailer, because I thought it was strong enough on its own to win.
Honestly, I feel that, no shade, I wouldn't have voted for it knowing it was a homemade trailer.
Okay.
You know, I wanted the official, but I understand
but
some of these.
Did you think
trailers.
It? Did you think it was a homemade trailer?
No, I didn't get that.
See,
yeah.
I think that's pretty good. If you can make a trailer and it not come off like that's why I didn't want to say anything.
Big Row One has done some trailers in the past too, which I wouldn't even have guessed. So I think they've got like the vibe down.
Hack-O-Lantern's on Tubi. Cool.
I'll give you a pass. You did a good job, and it was good, but if I was like, hey, and this is a fan-made submission, but again, some of those other ones we had that were edited, you know, where do you draw the line, right?
Yeah. All right, so...
Show that scene.
All right, we're headed into the semifinals. We'll show off the bracket right now. I'm going to adjust it for a second. Sorry. There we go. All right, there we go. Going into the semifinals, we have Flange against fourth seed Grimward, sixth seed Hendo against seventh seed Big Row. Things are heating up around here.
Things are getting hot.
So, if you just heard your name called out, please submit your trailers for the semifinals. Please submit your trailers for the semifinals.
Looks like we'd need one from Flange and Big Row, I think. Let me see.
Yeah, okay, that's the last round.
Somebody might have sent two at once. This is why we ask one at a time. All right, now, and then...
All right, okay.
So...
No. Yeah. All right, this is the semis. You know, if you win this one, you're on to the finals. And if you're in the finals, that's a 50-50 chance for you to be a champion. Okay, we got that one.
These two. Click on it. Yeah, that's where it is. Make sure they're not the same. Okay.
Okay.
All right.
All right.
Let's check the scene preview before we go there. Alright, looks good. Alright, and this is the first trailer of the semifinals.
I think I get what the... Alright.
What do you say?
I saw 1 second of this trailer and the title of this one, and I think I know what it's going to be about. And,
okay.
Yeah.
In case you didn't know, Wing Wing is Agent 00, and he's back with more adventure in For Your Height Only. Yes, Agent 00 is back, and he's more defiant, more daring.
Is he from Rock and Roll?
More full of surprises.
Is that the guy?
For Your Height Only, it has more thrills, more action, more chills, more skills. Agent 00, he's more full of fighting fury than before. Join him and Yellen Catral, Carmi Martini, Ana Marie Gutierrez, Beth Sandoval, his group of intrepid crimebusters as they ram through a network of syndicates and bust them wide open to save society from oppression in the name of justice.
This is like the Milo and Otis of this movie.
Yeah, there was
so many people died during this scene.
Face it, there is no one as compelling or as big in the world of Secret Service agents as 00, with always a trick up his sleeve.
Like,
nobody does it more conventionally.
I think it was, because I think they said he's bad.
More unconventionally as Agent 00. Mark it well. This is Agent 00, and he will stop at nothing to get his man in. For Your Height Only.
He looks like the girl.
I think the guy from Dr. Moore was much smaller. That's dope. That's dope. Down the baddest town in Chicago.
Wing Wing, I don't know what
Agent
00,
and
Tony Bergman
take you on a high ride to entertainment for
Hilarious.
Your height
Dudes.
Only.
Much
is that Devo? Did he just kill Devo?
Yeah.
Agent 00 is still on our side, and he'll be landing in this theater soon.
Theater.
Okay. That was called For Your Height Only. What do you think of that, Sam?
I thought that was really fun. I thought it was odd that it's called For Your Height Only. The big kind of like, you know, game of the movie is that the guy's short And yet, it's like, we're so far into the trailer before you see the guy standing next to a person.
I know. You know, I thought like that opening part with like the circle, like the Bondi shit, would have been like, it would have shown him next to like somebody of a normal stature.
Or like, maybe it's like goes over and then down.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's not that. Yeah.
That's why you're a writer. That was weird. And again, like, did it say he's back? Because I would hope that's like a series of shit.
I believe it is a series.
Because that would be funny as fuck.
Wang Wang. And I don't think he's the guy from Island of Dr. Moreau.
Yeah, I think the guy from Island of Dr. Moreau was like very tiny, like this big. That guy was like 4 feet tall.
In 1981. There was, I think, a movie called Agent 00.
Okay. They didn't call him Agent 00, yeah. Labarca says, Mr. Giant has kidnapped the brilliant Dr. Von Kohler and is planning to use the doctor's invention, the N-bomb, to hostage. The only one who can foil Mr. Giant's evil scheme is Agent 00. Oh, because Giant, get it? 3-foot-tall Filipino martial artist, master, expert marksman, top-class romancer, and all-around super spy. Can Agent 00 rescue Dr. Kohler before it's too late?
He was also in a movie called Wild Wild Wang and The Search for Wang Wang.
Spuden says this is the sequel to Agent 00.
Yeah, yeah, that's
right.
I
don't know.
I think Agent 00 is the first one.
Yeah. Huh.
He's also in a movie called The Cute, the Sexy, and the Tiny. It's funny how his...
Cute, the Sexy, and the Tiny? Okay.
All right.
Sexy and Tiny don't seem like they should be, like, together, right? As words?
Kyle S.K. Wig Elf says, any talk of a Mars trailer yet? No, but Zach's movie has a trailer that just came out, so there's that. So how about Mars? Any news on Mars? We're going to be done in September.
So the earliest somebody should look for a trailer is like September, like October?
I don't know.
Okay.
We might be like, when we're getting close in September, we might be able to like have them put together a trailer in August.
Sure.
But that's not because it's going to be released immediately. We're going to enter it into festivals and stuff like that to try and get distribution and stuff. So
Trick Simon Riley says, play Zach's trailer. We already did at the top of the show. We're in a tournament now playing head-to-head stuff. It's on YouTube. Alright, so the first trailer of the semifinals announces the second trailer is going to be head-to-head. The Your High Norm versus...
I just didn't know where else to go.
It must be pretty valuable for someone to kill over it.
So we're at its dead end.
I recognize it. Robert Carpathian.
Okay, cool.
My friend Lyle's a caterer down in Sedona. Carpathian is famous for his weekend pool orgies.
Once you finish serving, I'll send you in the house for some water. You can change your clothes in the pantry. The office is upstairs, right?
Yeah. And if they catch you, just tell them you're up there changing clothes to get some swimming in. He could be trouble. You better watch out for him.
He could be trouble. How he goes?
Bingo.
Steve Rambo.
Is that what he is?
Son of a bitch.
Tell us, Mr. Sexy.
Yeah.
fucking did you hear the gunshots out of the gun? I think this is a Struggle says, I'm starting to think this movie might be a little gay. Join the club. They are trying to recruit us. They're trying to make us aroused by watching their trailers.
It could be like an actual pornographic movie.
Pornographic. Pornographic?
Pornographic.
Pornographic. Pornographic?
Pornography. Pornographic.
Pornographic.
Same word. But it could be an actual, like, they just come around.
Wait. The person who made it posted this clip on YouTube, so I just want to read. It blows my mind to this day when Catalina Collection posted the movie on their site. It got a ridiculous amount of views. I wonder why.
Yeah.
I haven't seen this movie in maybe 20 years or so, and revisiting it while cutting this new trailer brought back so many memories. Ray Harley was new with us. In fact, we shot his Colorado scene and his other scenes for the movie when he was introduced in Meet Ray Harley on the same trip. Little did Rambo and Harley know that this would catapult both of their careers. Yeah, this has to be a porn.
Keep reading.
In addition to Rambo winning Best Actor and Cole Tucker winning Best Supporting Actor and Best Oscars. Performances, Tom Walker also won Best Non-Sexual Performer.
It's one of those non-televised Academy Awards.
Oh, yeah.
Did that the week before. Best Non-Sexual Performer.
The best... This week we had the technical Oscars where we gave many Academy Awards to special effects and lighting and non-sexual performers. It was freezing that night. We shot in the sewer, but Rambo and Tom were both in it to win it. The water was like 60 degrees. All in all, we shot on Catalina Island. It was supposed to be a private beach scene, but when a snorkeling group showed up, we had to get in our little boat and head to sea. Chicago, during International Mr. Leather, Scottsdale, Arizona, Breckenridge, Colorado, and Los Angeles. I guess they're just...
So definitely, do you think like the movie actually has like gay porn scenes in it?
If you're giving one of the actors an award for being a non-sexual performer, and other actors in the movie won Best Actor and Best Supporting Actor,
yeah,
I think there's.
I mean, the trailer they had like enough to be like it looked like a legitimate movie. Man, that is funny. That is really funny. So. Just to recap, what is Catalinaville going up against? I also like how they named the movie after like the production company.
Yeah, yeah.
Catalina Home Video presents Catalinaville.
All right. Semifinals, match one.
Yeah. Did that movie give you, did that trailer give you a semi finally?
Yeah, finally. What? This is what an erection is?
It feels fuller. Why is that?
Yeah.
I've had erections before, but this one's just really strong.
Yeah.
So, we have Catalinaville going up against for your height only.
Your.
You heard? And so if you are, again, not watching but listening, or you're in driving a truck and you're watching live, you should pull over and get ready to vote in chat. Because that's what time it is.
Okay, poll's going up. And, wait, poll's going up now.
What do you think of those movies, Sam?
I mean,
let me rephrase. What's your takeaway from Your Height Only?
My takeaway, a lot of fun kookiness, a lot of like funny bits in the trailer, and it was very odd. Catalina Ville, it's this genre of movies that I'm not really familiar with, and you know, much like you and Indonesian cinema, maybe there's more movies like this out there.
I hear that. And what about gay porn in general? What do you feel about gay porn in general?
I was just talking about gay porn.
Well, okay. The poll is in.
Oh, wow.
You missed voting. And it looks like Catalina Ville won with 25-9. Let's see. Do you know who did those? I was not
paying. Catalina Ville is the winner.
Catalina Ville comes to us from Big Row 1.
Big Row 1 is going on to the finals, guys.
Edging out Hendo.
Edging out Hendo maybe in multiple ways.
That's sexual.
Hendo is what a mensch there. Congratulating Big Row 1 on their Big Row win. Okay, now to figure out who else is going into the finals, we know this is going to be either a Flanja trailer or a Grimward trailer.
Correct. One or the other.
One or the other.
What is this? No, we'll talk about.
That was just Nate just pointed to a window. I have a tab. I have of just
what is this? Of all my personal information and passwords.
What is this? CatalinaProductions.com.
What is this folder? It says, nope, you got the wrong thing.
Oh, whoop.
You want to... down here, yeah. The folder is My Poetry. But it's only video files inside.
Okay.
Nice. All right, this is second match.
Looks like she was put in the car when she was still alive.
Ooh,
and then drowned. Look at her nails. See how they're cut and torn? Looks like she was trying to claw her way out. You should see the expression on her face.
Ooh, that's a good...
You know, I hate to bring this up, but you are married to the perfect man.
I don't know.
Car popped up out of Half Moon Marsh. Had a woman's body in it.
And he's becoming awfully compulsive with Amy. He doesn't just take care of her. He studies her.
What do we got now? Two moms disappear from the same playground.
You could get us all put away for good.
I have this horrible feeling that it has something to do with his father.
I did nothing. I don't even exist.
This thing you're doing means everything to the old man.
I won't hurt her!
She'll hurt you!
We gotta find these women now. I don't want to be walking behind any lousy coffins.
Do you think he was younger than you were?
I want to know what you've done with Amy!
I don't know where she is!
I do. Yeah. You should never have gotten out.
Dr. Walheim!
You're nothing but a cheap hoodlum. I am what you made me, Dad.
I know what you're going to do! It's a bad thing, and I'm gonna tell.
It was Bonesy! He did it again!
Let's
my wife.
You saw us in the park together, didn't you?
I'm not gonna let that loving wife of yours sell you down the river.
Give me my child!
What do you think?
I think...
Hickory dickory, Doc. Kane has picked his lock.
That's the sequel to Citizen Kane. Yeah. That was the... I think, if I'm keeping track, that's the third trailer that I just genuinely was like, oh, I like this trailer.
Have you not seen that movie?
I have not seen that movie. Have you seen it?
I know I've seen it because it's like a movie Sully liked.
Yeah.
But I don't really remember it.
I
wonder how many different characters. It's like...
I always would get that confused with Jacob's Ladder.
Oh. I wonder if this is like John Lithgow's... that Eddie Murphy movie where he plays all the characters.
Clumps? The Nutty Professor?
The Nutty Professor, yeah. This is John Lithgow's Nutty Professor. Yeah, they're like, can you do a German accent? He's like, yes. I can do anything you want me to. yeah, that looked like a good movie. And, you know, the thing is, like, I don't know movies like you or Timmy or whatever, but, you know, I recognize the name Brian De Palma, and I'm like, oh, you know, I'd watch that. That looks like a genuine movie I would watch. We're going next. Ready for this?
We have infiltrated many such churches throughout the nation because we are about to usher in a new dawning in history.
Do you know what you need? You need the Lord.
But in this Aquarian age, we are about to unfold the New World Order.
The fact is, not only am I not really a Baptist preacher, but I've been a Jesuit priest.
Perhaps this will end your skepticism.
Catholicism, Buddhism, Hinduism, Shamanism, Protestantism. How do you bring all these things together and reconcile them under one religion?
Can't you see that we are on the brink of bringing the world to peace?
Oh, the religious ranks, that's what I'm here for.
Peace, just like in the Garden of Eden. We're trying to make a world that all of us are gathered together as brothers, and all of these religions can practice their religion because we all can join in with them, and it'll all be under the authority of the Pope.
How do you know that they're not duking you like the rest?
Shut up! I've had enough of you. I'm not going to sit here and allow you to blaspheme the Virgin Mary and the saints of God.
Why did you hit me in the chin with that fry pan?
You're lucky I didn't use my machete.
The funny thing is, like, I don't know a lot about religion, but I felt like all other, like, Christian religions hated Catholics. No? And that was, like, a Baptist church production? Or was the Catholic guy the bad guy?
I think maybe. I think that was the big twist.
It was, like, the Catholic guy
was
the
he was
guy.
Like, I was also a Jesuit priest. Dun, dun, dun! Yeah.
And the Pope should tell us what to do. So yeah. It was like, that was weird.
That was very weird. It that ended so strong.
What kind of camera do you think they used there?
Well, it says on the video, it says that they used an iPhone 6S to shoot that movie. Movie filmed on iPhone 6S. Christian thriller.
The iPhone 8 was out. But yeah. Wasn't in the budget.
Yeah.
Okay. So,
all right.
These are two very different movies. I feel a lot of the head-to-heads like have had kind of some like similar vibes. are not all of them, but you can find threads. These ones I feel like could be the most different of the movies that we have in a head-to-head matchup. So Raising Cain is a Brian De Palma movie about like schizophrenia, maybe, you know, like a murder thing.
I guess they're both thrillers. I mean,
is Elijah's Secret a thriller?
It says right there, Christian thriller.
Oh, is the thriller part that he's a Jesuit priest?
I think so. I mean, there are some gunshots in it.
Yeah. The guy ran into the woods with the smallest gun I've ever seen in somebody's hand.
Why'd you hit me with that pan? You're lucky I didn't hit you with my machete.
It's like, well, the question's still there. Why would you hit me with a machete?
All right, the poll is up.
The poll is live, guys. This is the last match
both,
of the semifinals.
Both have biblical names. That is Elijah and Cain.
True. And it kind of looked like John Lithgow was playing like a pastor or a preacher in one of those.
A Jesuit lessons. Priest. Yeah, one of those was a Jesuit priest.
I wonder.
Dun, dun, dun. That freak out at the end of... That's really close for me. I think I'll vote.
All right. Still sure. Oh, Catalinaville.
Really?
Yeah. Anybody else?
What were you going to vote for?
You know what I think? I'm voting for Elijah.
Could have helped it.
Yeah, polling come up. Raising Cain!
Raising Cain was the winner. That was probably the closest for me yet.
For you personally?
Yeah, that was the hardest for me to pick.
Well, it got a little blown out here. It was 22 votes to 12. I don't know who did this.
That was Flanja gets eliminated. Flanja! So, yet again,
the favorite
person who wins the season does not win the tournament.
Wow.
So that is still a crown yet to be held.
Flanja.
And the winner in the finals, going on to the finals, is Grimward. Grimward, who was so down on themselves going into this, was like just almost just giving up going into this.
Grimward is again, like, I think, times it's like
okay.
5 a.m. for Grimward.
Grimward?
So they're hanging out.
So you got one more.
So Grimward and Big Row 1, submit your final trailers. This is for
Abby Sellers. This is upsetting. I'm going to storm a Raising Cane's. We could. There's a Raising Cane's that just opened up down the street. We could storm that too in honor.
Oh, it's new.
It's brand new.
See, the Popeyes looks like old and beat down and they're out of everything. So I feel like going to a newer one would be a better, because the Raising Cane's near me is like shitty.
No, this is weirdly nice. Like, weirdly nice.
Okay. All right, so next up, guys, we have the finals. You want to throw up the brackets again?
So all right, just so we can see them.
One last time.
One last time. All right.
Boop. So, we've come a long way. Big Row has come from the bottom. Big Row is in that elimination round one.
And now Big Row's here.
All the way. From the bottom, now he's here. Pretty impressive.
Grimward
was, I think, fourth seed.
Fourth seed, yeah.
So Grimward was in the, top half of favorites to win. Flanja is still reeling.
Oh, Flanja.
Hendo felt so bad they gifted a bunch of
stuff. Oh, yeah. We'll have you guys bet. That's totally true, is that we can have you guys bet on the winner.
Yeah, predictions. And that's cool, too, because they're not going to know who's who, so it's just totally randos.
Oh, yeah. So we have to watch the trailers first, and then we'll do the... Wait. Oh, they won't know. Oh, yeah, I see what you're saying.
They're just picking a person that's going to win without seeing their trailers.
Yeah. And then they'll vote on trailer, hoping what they did.
Yeah. So while, we're doing that, if you haven't watched the news as an American and you saw the Roe vs. Wade stuff, and that's like fucked up. Do what you can. Fuck some shit up. Talk to some people that are like against Roe vs. Wade and be like, this is fucked up.
Maybe if you live in a state where abortion is being made illegal, get active with one of these charities that helps people leave the state, venture out of the state to get an abortion, which I think go to another state to get an abortion. I think it's really a handy thing to do.
That's I was not going to give a productive option, so go with his thing. Don't throw a brick through a window of a church.
I mean, but like,
I don't think that'd be a good one.
And I mean, just talk to people. Like, tell people that you're upset. Tell people why it's messed up.
I think that's the biggest thing, is talking to people and being like, this is why this is fucked.
And yeah, I mean, and you know, I'm about to have a kid, and I'll say this is like, a pregnancy, a wanted pregnancy, is still a very scary, very risky thing. And what is going on right now is dangerous. There are people who will want to have their baby, but be in a situation where it's in their best interest to, like, it's against, it's in the interest of their health to get an abortion, and to the baby's health maybe too, and they won't be able to get one. That will happen.
Yeah, I mean, that happens a lot more than you think it does. A friend of ours that happened to in 2021. And it was very sad. But imagine if it couldn't be like that. And she almost died. Anyway. Okay.
All right. We're doing the predictions right now.
All right. So, we haven't watched a single trailer yet. If you look in the chat now, prediction. Or it's only set for 1 minute. Should we give it a little more time?
No, just 1 minute. It's okay. Just the prediction.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So, you can bet points now with the prediction thing. Again, we're going Grimward versus Big Row 1 for all the marbles. I think, you know, Grimward and Big Row 1 both started later than a lot of the other competitors we have. So I am a big fan of the stuff they've brought to the table, and they caught up. They caught up a lot of room. And, the thing is, I don't think either of these guys were in the first tournament of season one, because Niamix, Shringles, and Flanja were all in the first season tournament.
True, yeah.
And they all got knocked out. So this is pretty crazy, guys. This is pretty crazy. Professor Marth is here, who won the last tournament. I didn't know if Marth would be available. So Marth...
Marth wants to see the upset. Marth is voting underdog.
Yeah. Was Marth an upsetter?
I think so. I think Marth was a pretty low-seated person.
You know what, I feel Marth always brought the heat, though. So, I think...
Yeah, Marth frequently upsets everyone.
Let's see. So, whichever one of you guys wins, you'll be in good company. Again, we do have trophies that'll go out at some point. We haven't selected them yet.
Okay, the predictions are in, and...
That's close.
52% are saying... Big Row 1, the underdog will win. 52% are betting on the underdog.
Okay, let's see what we got. Did they submit? Yes, they both did.
Does that make him still the underdog? I don't know.
I don't know. Well, he's just seated lower, right?
Yeah, I guess. Yeah.
Big Row 1 came again from the pre-round. What do you call that?
The play-in.
The plan?
The play-in.
The play-in.
Alright, do you think they chose to hold on to their heat?
I think so. That's the thing, is that there's a lot of strategy involved, because it's like, do you pocket something that's dope, but you may lose it in an earlier round, or do you come with your heat early, and then you're like, fuck, I don't know what I'm going to do with the later round, you know? Like, I don't know what you do there.
Grass is green and skies are blue.
The
The love of a child is the most powerful force in the world. It must be protected and nurtured. Some are coming in search of the truth, others to observe and to control. The loss of a child is the most devastating force on Earth.
It's the guy from...
It is the ultimate test.
What's his name? There's something white.
It's just not what you're used to.
Tonight will be the greatest.
It's the guy from God.
You're going to make me angry.
Your children will die tonight.
Someone has to save the children. Someone must listen for the bells of innocence. We will have their souls.
We shall see, Joshua.
Norris Filmworks. Mike Norris.
Directed by Mike Norris.
Wow. Good on them.
Mike, you don't think he's related to... No.
No, just it's a common name.
I think the other guy in that movie, I want to check this out.
The guy with the silver hair?
The guy with the big forehead.
They look like James Van Der Beek?
No, not that. That guy's the guy from God's Not Dead.
Oh.
I gotta look this up, but what was that called?
It was called Bells of Innocence. Bells of Innocence. I couldn't tell, like, I kept going back and forth. Like, I think now I feel that was a religious, like, Christian movie.
Oh yeah, it definitely was.
But I couldn't I wasn't sure at first. You know what I'm saying? Like, I was like, oh, it's a Christian movie. And then I was like, wait, maybe it's not a Christian movie. And then I was like, no, it's definitely a Christian movie. So I was going back and forth.
No, it was definitely a Christian. The way the guy, the last frame is like the sunset with the...
Yeah, well, that the last frame, that's when, you know, it came back to me. But
I guess...
The part with the zombies, I was like, oh, I guess this isn't a Christian movie. It's like a zombie, like, horror. It's just kind of like this low-budget Western thing, you know? But yeah, like, does zombies now, like, looking back at it, I'm like, what do the zombies have to do with it? It's free on YouTube. Christianity has zombies too. It has one main zombie. It's got a pretty well-known zombie.
Oh, that was Mike Norris, was the guy with the big forehead.
Okay. Who was the guy with the silver hair? What is he from?
Let me see.
That was like a haircut, like, if you saw it in public, you'd be like, that guy's really into, like, German, like, craft work.
He was in Roadhouse, apparently.
Oh.
I don't know who he was in Roadhouse, but...
Sam and Nate got a Dewey Cali glow. It's called Sweat.
Yeah.
It's very fucking hot here.
Okay. Is this all ready?
It should be. And this is the last trailer of the night for the finals.
Just tell me, what's playing here? Star Wars, right? Star Wars?
Star Wars?
Yes!
Master of the world, and though he was
Steven Spielberg.
You're kidding, right?
You're a weird kid, Johnson.
You are going to find the perfect girl for you really soon. And then you'll finally lose your virginity.
Cut!
Pat, to everybody else, movies are something to do when you're tired of real life.
Cut!
To you, real life is something to do when you're tired of watching movies.
Herb Lightman.
He's been making these little movies since he was 9. You know, with the home movie camera his dad left behind.
Take it out.
But they're really something.
Yeah, real bad.
So here's what I was wondering.
I can do that.
When this movie comes out, it's going to be like Woodstock.
I'm thinking Nerdstock.
So where do your alien relatives come from?
A distant star system.
Yeah, what's it called?
Hollywood.
What's with Johnson?
He's like some kind of sci-fi sea insect.
I have you now.
Just don't forget I did this.
What did you say?
You think because you can direct little Super 8 movies, you can direct how people's lives are gonna turn out?
We may be geeks on the outside, but on the inside, we're all killer apes.
I'm not what you are.
Oh no, I'm not nuts. I'm a ball. My ancestors touched the monolith.
Kid from Freaks
Your and ancestors Geeks. Watched.
There's this thing in it called the Death Star, which could take out the Enterprise with one shot.
The Enterprise has deflector shields!
I want to see that.
It looks cool.
Yeah, yeah, I've never heard of that. It's from 2017, so it's not even that old. I've never heard of that. I would watch the shit out of that. It said it was based on a true story. Who's was that a real name of somebody you'd heard of?
What was the name?
Patrick something. I didn't know. I didn't recognize the name. It said it in the beginning when it was like he was like 8 and he saw 2001 Space Odyssey. Interesting. Those was also two very different things, because it's like, all right, so the religious movie trailer was great. Watch a trailer, silly, weird, but it's like, I don't want to see that movie. And this is like a trailer where it like makes you want to see the movie. So it's like, the other trailer isn't bad because it doesn't want to make me see it.
What was that fucking other trailer called?
It was Bells of Innocence.
Bells of Innocence.
Of course, Bells of Innocence.
I was like, why can't
this movie was called 52577, which I think is probably like an awful name for a movie.
It sounds like that. It's like, oh yeah, I don't want to see that Stephen King miniseries. So yeah, it's the one about the time traveling Kennedy assassination thing.
Is that with like James Franco?
With James Franco, yeah.
Yeah. All I know is that it's a Stephen King thing and James Franco, but I couldn't tell you what the name is. It's like my favorite Adidas shoes are called, they were called the Nikes, and then they changed the number to I5987, but it's like four numbers that I don't remember. So it's like I have to like Google it every time I want to find them. So, oops. 52577. Awful name for a movie. Looks like a good movie though. Like I want to watch it. Maybe that's why I don't know it or never heard of it.
Because Mythic
of
the name. CDXX just throws in John Oliver looks like Harry Potter and Austin Powers in the LGBT community had a baby.
Was he in that movie?
I don't think so. Okay. I don't know why that was thrown out.
Is he in one of these still frames then?
All right, but the vote's up right now for the finals.
Oh, shit,
should
yeah.
Should I cancel this?
Yeah, cancel it. All right,
wait, this doesn't count. This doesn't count. This doesn't count. This poll doesn't count. The poll doesn't count.
We're redoing. Should we give it a 3-minute poll to give people some time?
Yeah, we'll give it a 3-minute poll. This poll doesn't count. Poll doesn't count.
We're not counting it because we were talking and forgot to tell people to vote. Because a lot of people...
We don't have a winner.
Not paying attention.
I was screaming, poll doesn't count, the whole time.
Yeah, that got far less actual votes than before. So, letting people know... The poll's going to go up now. We should put it up for like 3 minutes.
To get yeah, sorry, to that was my fault.
Yeah.
Bells of what? Innocence?
Both the names of those are not great. All right, while that's up for 3 minutes, I want you to tell me. So we just watched Bells of Innocence and 5/25/77, based on a true story. Of the trailers we saw tonight, what was your favorite one?
The trailers we saw tonight, I think my earlier answer stands, that what was that one? The one that is actually sticking out in my head right now is Stunt Rock, but there was that other one that I was like so into.
Before Stunt Rock?
It was after Stunt Rock. And it was like a big it was also a stunty one.
I mean, we saw a lot of stunty ones.
And I was talking about how it was my favorite trailer of the night. It wasn't Thunder Cops, no.
The Sweeper, was it?
The Sweeper, yes. Sweeper was one of my favorites. I think it would be Sweeper, Stunt Cops. What was that one that you just had up? The
Avenging Angel?
Oh no, that's the Sweeper. Yeah. The Sweeper had the plane stunt.
I really like The Man from Hong Kong, and I'm like shocked that I went down.
Yeah, Man
and
from
even
Hong
Caught
Kong?
Though, I thought Caught, were those the same round?
I think so. I think it was Caught versus
I thought Caught was hilarious. All right, so actually I'll say Catalinaville, I think, because it broke my brain.
Or Stunt Rock, not Stunt Cops.
Stunt Cock.
Do they call it Stunt Cops?
I do want to see Bad Times at the El Royale. I think Catalinaville, not a movie I'll see, but I just think like it's so funny that we watched like a trailer like that on the show, you know?
Young Evangelist, I mean, I'm still like, I have to go back and see what the first thing that character said in that trailer.
Yeah, because it was real like mushmouthy.
So mushmouthy.
Yeah.
Although we can do that now while we're waiting. Who is that one?
That might be it.
Is this one?
I don't know. It didn't give us a preview, so it's hard to tell. Oh yeah, fuck, Mystics of Bali.
Mystics of Bali was good.
I think that might be my favorite one, is the Mystics of Bali.
That one I think lost, right?
Yeah, it did. But that was like, that one I thought was super, super weird. But in the same vein, Thunder Cops, Mystics of Bali, both of those are pretty cool. Bells of Innocence was Chuck Norris, Christian one.
Oh,
and some zombies.
Big Row One was the one who, Big Row One.
You must love going to church because you're always reading the Bible.
Ever since I got saved, I feel different. I feel good.
What did he say?
This winter.
I feel different.
You must love going to church because you're always reading the Bible.
Ever since I got saved, I feel different. I feel good inside.
This winter, experience what critics are calling.
All right, we got a winner. Let's see. I want to see what the points were. All right, 21-15, 5/25/77 is the winner, and that makes us this is the person who won.
Big Row One.
From the bottom.
From the bottom to the top.
From the bottom to the top. 21-15.
The big upset.
Wow. All the way from the bottom. The most trailers submitted. Wow. Congratulations.
Wow. You really had to earn it this time, huh? All right. So,
I wish we had like a button that was like, bam, bam. Didn't you have like a sound cues? That's all you get. Oh, that was for. Hey!
And to. It was Big Row One going up against
Grimward.
Who? Grimward? To yeah, Grimward?
It wasn't that long ago. But I will say, big ups to both of those guys. Oh. Why do I have this going on?
I don't know, move.
Sorry.
Just do this.
Oh.
Yeah.
Sorry. Oh, because I was supposed to be on that thing.
You were, I mean, you were, yeah.
Okay. Well, congratulations all around. Congratulations to everybody. Thank you guys very much. Everybody that was in the tournament, please send me your physical mailing addresses to the Trailer Boys email, and I'll show you guys what we're getting, what you're getting. I'm going to make the trophies, I think, this time.
Cool.
So it took a long time last time, but we had them made, but I think we should figure something else out.
Yeah.
Weird.
Yeah.
And so, thank you guys very much. That was a pretty fun tournament. Again, Sam, say goodbye to Sam. This is going to be his last Trailer Boys for a little bit. But, I mean, if we're like, hey, we're doing the show, and he's like, hey, I'm around, we'll go. Or call it or something. So it's not like your last Trailer Boys, but it's like your last regular. Like, and we're not planning on it.
Yeah.
If you're available, you're available. And then Trailer Boys, we'll be taking a bit of a break. I'm traveling. I am here in sweaty Southern California. It is nice, though. It does look pretty. But it's fucking hot as shit. It's going to be a bit, again, there is the subreddit Trailer Boys. You'll recognize a lot of the names from this chat and from the show into that subreddit as well. Sam, why are you leaving? Sam's having a baby like very, very soon.
I'm having a baby.
So Sam's life is going to be not plannable. So. Yeah. He's really, shooting for...
And guys, yeah. I was going to abort this baby, and then all this stuff happened, and now you guys are losing your stream.
It's your fault?
It's your fault.
Yeah. Okay. Well, you want to raid somebody? You want to say thanks? Is there anything you want to tell everybody? Is self-suck coming? No, I'm not saying, is there anything you have to tell anybody?
Oh, yeah.
Self-suck isn't this weekend, right? It's not tomorrow, but it's a week later, maybe?
It's a week later, yeah.
But you're on, a wait and see, because, Sam might have a baby.
Yeah.
Thank you guys very much again. Thank you to everybody that made time for us. I apologize for last week. Thank you for showing up. Thank you for submitting trailers. Everyone congratulate everyone that took part, but especially Big Row 1.
Congrats,
Season
Big Row 1.
Two, Tournament 2 Invitational Champion puts you up in the rarefied air with Professor Marth Live. Flanja, you're the winner of the season, but the loser of the tournament. You're up there with the rarefied air of panel, which you'll be getting a trophy for the season.
And it's good that that's still on the double crown has not been met yet,
Oh, yeah.
That goal has yet to be achieved. There's still, mountains left to climb.
We need to make a third type of tournament so there could be
triple crown, yeah. All right.
Thanks, everybody. Where are we going, Sammy?
Chapo Trap House?
Okay, Chapo Trap House.
All right, guys, have fun hanging out with Chapo Trap House.
Tell them we said hello.
With the Chapsters. The Traps. Chapos?
Chapos?
Chaps?
Oh, we forgot to call these the Trailos.
Yeah, these are called the Trailos, by the way.
Or the Goobos?